Let's look at debt and equity financing options. So when a corporation is trying to fund a large project, they basically have two options. They could issue stock and get money from that, or they could issue bonds. Both of these options is going to result in a cash inflow, the money coming in that they need. Now, if they issue stock, they're not going to have any interest payments, so that's good because interest is cash they have to pay. But it could dilute stockholder control because now you're going to have more shares outstanding. Also, if a corporation typically pays dividends, then if they issue more shares, that's more dividends they might have to pay out in the future. And there's no tax savings for dividends. Dividends are not tax deductible for corporations. If they issue bonds, however, that will increase liabilities, which is generally considered a bad thing to have more liabilities. But the bonds require interest payments, and interest payments are tax deductible. So interest payments do reduce the taxes that corporations have to pay. Also, by issuing bonds, stockholder control is not affected because the number of shares outstanding doesn't change, which also means that the return on common stockholders' equity could be higher because there's fewer shares outstanding. So let's look at a numerical example. Westmoreth Airlines is considering two alternatives for the financing of a purchase of a fleet of airplanes. So alternative number one is to issue shares of common stock, and alternative number two is to issue some bonds. If both are going to result in the money coming in that they need, it's just which one should they do and how does that impact net income? So let's look at our two alternatives. So first we need to see how does this impact net income. And so the problem tells us that the company will earn $770,000 before interest and taxes. So under both scenarios here, we start at $770,000. Now, if the corporation chooses to issue stock, then they do not have any interest payments. However, if they issue bonds, they're going to have to pay 6% interest on those bonds. So we can calculate then that if the corporation does plan two, they're going to have an additional $202,500 of interest expense. And that interest expense is going to decrease their income. Now, under both scenarios, the corporation will have to pay tax, but now it's going to be based off of a different amount for their income before taxes. And so in our problem, the estimated tax rate is 40%. And so if we take 40% times the income before taxes, we can see that if they issue stock, their tax expense would be $308,000. But if they issue bonds, it actually goes down to $227,000. So they actually would end up paying less in taxes, which again is actual cash they have to pay, and that's why it's important. And then we can subtract out the income tax expense and determine that under plan one, net income would end up at $462,000. Under plan two, issuing bonds, it would be lower at $340,500. However, they are paying less taxes. Now we need to look at and say, okay, how does this impact earnings per share? So our earnings per share is net income divided by the shares outstanding. And so we just calculated net income for the two scenarios. And now we need to look at the shares. So the problem tells us that before they do anything, they have 107,000 shares of common stock outstanding. So that's our starting point under both scenarios. Now, if they issue shares of stock, that obviously is going to result in more shares outstanding. And so if we look up here, our problem tells us it's 112,500 shares that they would be issuing. Now, if they issue bonds, that is no additional shares that would go out, so that's zero. So after financing, they end up with 219,500 shares outstanding if they choose the stock option. So now we can calculate earnings per share and take the net income under each scenario, divide it by the outstanding shares under each scenario. And now we've calculated that if they plan to issue stock, earnings per share would be $2.10. If they do the financing where they issue the bonds, earnings per share is actually higher at $3.18. So even though net income was lower if they issue bonds, earnings per share ends up higher because there's fewer shares outstanding. And that earnings per share number is a really important number to investors. They really like to look at that and see if it's being consistent or if it's growing over time. Okay, so there is no correct answer for the company of whether or not they choose to issue stock or bonds. It's just important to see how the two options impact net income and also the earnings per share.